Tonight, both campaigns for and against Maps 3 are trying to push their agenda. The $777 million project will build a new city park and a new convention center. But some say this is not the right time for Maps, and the city needs to focus on public safety. Eyewitness News 5's Linda Mata spoke to people on both sides. She's live with the new details. Linda?
Jessica, the Maps 3 debate is heated up. I have talked to several people over the last few days who have strong opinions on both sides of the issue.
Time is running out for opponents and supporters of Maps 3, and both sides are making sure their voice is heard.
It's a bad plan.
That's what some think.
Let's talk about the deficiencies in the plan. Let's talk about why it doesn't address the needs of public safety and public transportation.
But there is a big push to get Maps 3 passed, and supporters are doing all they can to remind voters to come out tomorrow.
If you're going to attract the highly educated young people, you're going to have to create a job that they're going to want to stay.
But that battle is heating up as the election nears.
I think so. I think when you have a funded opponent and the unions have a funded bank account that they put into this, you're going to have more noise created, more media created, and just a higher level of anxiety about whether or not it's going to pass.
We care about the community, and to say that we don't care about it is unfair, is grossly unfair. To talk about this in terms of contractual issues and about the labor organizations making demands that we feel like is grossly unfair.
Come tomorrow, the citizens of Oklahoma City will express their opinions when they cast their Maps 3 ballot.
And if the Maps 3 vote does pass, the city will extend a penny cent sales tax for another 8 years. Reporting live, I'm Linda Mott, Eyewitness News 5.